हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर डी वी थोरात फ्रॉम केकेआर कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर नासिक एंड टुडे वी विल बिगिन विथ अवर न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज कंपोनेंट्स एंड रिलेवेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग. इन दैट वी विल गो विथ द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज कंपोनेंट ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग. इन दैट फर्स्ट कंपोनेंट ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग इज क्रॉप एंड सॉइल. ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग सिस्टम encourage the use of crop rotation and manures to maintain the soil fertility. Green manure and intercropping with a legume is important aspect for biological farming system. It not only reduces the weed but also reduces the leaching of nutrient and soil erosion. Depending on green manuring mixture or the legume used for the sowing, they maybe increase the soil organic matter and soil nitrogen as well as other nutrient. Next component is organic manures. Organic materials such as the FYM, biogas slurry, compost, straw, crop residue, green manure and cover crops are the good substitute for the inorganic fertilizer. Similarly, seaweed, fish manure, basic slag, rock phosphate also proved better. Organic materials help in improving the physicochemical properties of soil and reduces the soil erosion. Crop rotations, green manuring are known to be improve soil fertility. Next is non-chemical weed control. Weed control is one of the main concern in organic agriculture as use of a herbicide which is strictly prohibited due to environmental pollution. Crop rotations, green manuring, manure management, tillage generally used to prevent the weeds. In addition, mechanical and thermal methods also used in a pre-emerging system. Mulching is also used on a large scale to control the weed population into the field. And next one is a biological pest management, which is one of the challenging method or management system in organic farming, which is carried out by adopting different biopesticides and by using different insecticides, that is, and botanical pesticides, which is derived from the neem, as well as parasitoids like a trichogramma, insect pathogens like a bacillus thuringiensis and nuclear polyhydrosis virus are used to control disease and the pest population into the field. Next is history of organic farming. Organic movement began in 1930 and 1940 as a reaction to the agriculture growing reliance on the synthetic fertilizer. Artificial fertilizer had been created during the 18th century, initially with a superphosphate and then ammonia derived fertilizers mass produced using the Haber-Bosch process developed during the World War I, which result in increasing the chemical residues into soil, so that the Sir Albert Hubbard is widely considered as the father of organic farming, which is word for the organic agriculture and known as a father. Then Rudolf Steiner and the Australian philosopher made important strides in the earliest organic theory with his biodynamic agriculture. And after that, the United States, another founder of organic agriculture was J.I. Rodell in 1940. He founded the both a working organic farm for trials and experimentation. And the further work was done by the Lady Eve Wolfer in a UK. The next point is different institutes and organizations related to organic farming. And that first one is APIGR, that is Association for the Propagation of Indigenous Genetic Resources, which is established in the year 1984. Then next one is International Federation of Organic Agriculture Movement, which is established in the year 1972. Then APEDA, that is Agriculture and Processed Food Product Export Development Authority. Next one is National Program for Organic Production, which is established in the year 2001. Next, National Steering Committee. Then next, National Academy of Agriculture Science. Then next one is IOAS, that is International Organic Accreditation Service. Next one is Organic Agriculture Trade Zone. And the last one is Organic Agriculture in Rural Development. Next is Relevance of Organic Farming. In India, only 30% of total cultivable land area is covered with a fertilizer where the irrigation facilities are available, and the remaining land, that is 70%, which is mainly under the rainfed condition where the use of fertilizer is limited, so that such a land is considered as a land under the organic farming, where the only organic manure are the source of nutrient. In a northeastern hills of India, it provides the considerable opportunity for the organic farming due to least utilization of chemical inputs, which can be exploited for the organic production, that is 18 million hectares. Next, in India, is an exporting country and does not import any organic products. The main market for the exported products is the European Union. Recently, in India, has applied to be included on a UA third country list, another growing market in the USA. There has been party of policy emphasis on organic farming and trade in the recent years in India. During 10th 5-year plan, the government of India encourage and promote the organic farming in organic farming by using organic waste and integrated pest management and nutrient management. And also in the 9th 5-year plan, the Indian government promoted the organic produce in the plantation crops, spices, condiments with the use of organic and bio inputs. There are many states and provide agency which involved in a promotion of organic farming, that are universities and research center, then non-government organization, then eco-farmers, then certification bodies like IndoCert, EcoCert, SKL and APOF. Then in Uttar Pradesh and Uttaranchal, the diversified agriculture support project is promoted for the organic farming. Then in Bangalore and Nilgiris, with the 50 outlets in the South India, help for the supply of organic product from small growers. International recourses for the fairier trade based in Mumbai procures organic cotton and agro product to sell them to Indian and foreign buyers to help the poor people. Then different states such as Haryana, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka showing higher yield production, which is considered as a organic produce for the different commodities. Then next one is requirement of organic production. In that, first one is a landscape. To produce or to convert the conventional farming into organic farming, there is a requirement of inputs, or the characteristics of such inputs are taken into consideration. Then we will see the first input, that is landscape. The characteristics to be considered, that use of local soil, flora and fauna around the field suited to the region should be encouraged. Then action that affected to biodiversity should be restricted as far as possible. Then next one is a soil and water conservation. Relevant measures should be taken to prevent the soil erosion, conservation of water, prevent the both excess and improper use of water and pollution of ground as well as surface water. Prevalent measures should be taken to prevent the salinization. Then cleaning of land by burning of organic matter should be restricted to the absolute minimum. Then choice of crop and variety. Seed and planting material should be purchased from the traditional and certified organic production. Seed must be treated with the permissible product. Then when certified organic seed not available, chemically untreated seed, conventional material may be used. Then new crop seed and plant material should be not treated with synthetically pesticides and chemicals. Then use of genetically engineered seed, transgenic plant should not allowed. Then next is crop rotation. Certifying programs should set minimum standard for the crop rotation on arable land, taking into account the nature of crop, presence of weeds and local conditions. Certifying programs can accept intercropping as a part of crop rotation program, considering the various variations in the cropping length of different crop. Next one is manual policy. It includes the use of different manures such as FYM compost and vermicompost. It should not be treated with a chemical compound. It should used into its natural form and according to the standards of a certifying agency. It should be according to the standards of certifying agency. Avoid the use of synthetically nitrogenous fertilizer. And next point is pest, disease and weed management. To control the pest, disease and weeds into the field, we have to follow the different cultural practices and mechanical practices, biological control measures, so that we can maintain that population up to ETL level. And use of chemical inputs should be strictly prohibited. Next one is plant growth regulators. All synthetic products like growth regulators and dyes should not be used. Products of traditional nature, preferably prepared at the farm from local plants and animals and microorganisms, should be used. Next point is different between conventional and organic farming. That is, when we are going to compare the conventional farming with organic farming on the basis of economical orientations, the heavy mechanization and specialization and disappropriate development of enterprises with the unstable market oriented program. And in case of organic farming, efficient input use efficiency, diversification and balanced enterprises combination with the stability.